Hello and welcome to One Talk Radio podcast. My name is John Gora, the host of this podcast, and I'm with my co-host,
James Mumbi, a.k.a. Gishoro.
You can call me the motivator, and this is an episode that we bring you every week. And this week, we have a very important topic we are discussing with you, and that is early marriage. Sometimes it is very difficult to understand what exactly it means. I'll introduce my co-host here to explain to us what exactly it means to say somebody is married at an early age.
Well, thank you very much, Mr. John. I would like to say that early marriage is also termed as child marriage. And it is actually defined as a marriage that is done before the person attains 18 years of age. Now, early marriage is also termed as a human right violation, despite many laws being put in place in countries. Now, we do have some statistics from the UNICEF that shows this the number of people who have been affected by this tragedy. And I believe John is going to share the statistics so that we know where we are going and what should be done.
Right away, it is really interesting to understand that child marriage is affecting a very large number of our girls,
that's right,
and as well as boys. And as you have said, you know, a lot of people focus on ladies or girls in terms of child marriage. But do you think child marriage is only impactful or affecting the girl child? Do our boys also get affected in terms of, you know, getting married early? And do we really do some research in making sure that this is ascertained? Because the UNICEF research and statistics that I have talks about one girl in every five girls that you can put together being forced into a marriage before they attain or attain age that is allowed and acceptable within the society for marriage. That is 18 years. And, you know, it is also interesting to note that there is an improvement, or there is a good news that this number is declining by day.
Oh, so good.
If you look at, you know, like in the year 1985, they were talking about 63% of the girl child being married forcefully or before attaining the age of 18. But at around 2010, they were talking about 45%. Which is closely a good number. There's a decline in it.
I've said about the statistics that they have changed within time, and the improvement is better.
Okay.
We can see that in each year, 12 million girls get married under the age that is right, which is, I believe, before that, the year that you mentioned, it's quite a great improvement in that number. And I believe, hopefully, by next year, the statistics will change from 12 million to 11 million.
Then, when you look at these stats, if at all five girls or a group of five girls, one girl will be married at an age that is not acceptable within the society, what are we doing? What are the things that are pushing our girls to be married at this age?
Yeah.
Is it the parents? Is it the social well-being? Is it the economical, you know, problems? So this is what we need to go into. The effects, what are the causes? What are the push? What exactly, you know, leads to these early marriages? And as you can look at the research that you were doing with you, there are some of them that we can mention. James, I would allow you to, you know, take us through this. Some of the reasons why these girls drop, and what are the effects after dropping or after getting married within before attaining the age that is acceptable within the society?
Going to the effects of the early marriages, there are quite a number of things that normally come with this early marriage thing, or child marriage, as it's well known. You'll find that when you're getting married as a child, or most of the times you had not finished school. So what happens, you end up dropping out of school. And as a result of that, you end up staying at home, and you end up being oppressed financially, because you'll be depending on somebody who will be providing to you, for you, when he feels like. So that, now you find that a young man of 18, that's even 17 years old boy gets married. This person does not have the mental capability of raising a kid, not unless if the boy is born with a wisdom from heaven. But it's very difficult for that person. He's not ready mentally, psychologically, physically he might be ready,
yes,
but psychologically, mentally, and financially, mm-hmm, that person is not ready at all.
Mm-hmm.
So what happens is fights,
mm-hmm,
and misunderstanding. And that marriage, this is where you see there's a lot of suicide between marriages happening and couples killing each other,
mm-hmm,
because they are not psychologically ready. Mostly those who are married young.
Mm-hmm.
Now, when you come to the other gender, the, mm-hmm, girl side,
mm-hmm,
a girl, when she's married young, she is not ready to take care of the children. That is what I see.
Mm-hmm.
She needs to go under certain steps of counseling and guidance, so that she knows how to do and how to do things when such things comes along.
Mm-hmm.
This child, whenever, let's say when the girl is married now, not to the same age as the boy, mm-hmm, but when he's married to an old man,
mm-hmm,
the girl is being married against her will.
Yes.
So she will not be happy. She will be having stress all time.
Mm-hmm.
And she end up having post-traumatic stress, and again, like, she end up being in depression at the end of the day.
Mm-hmm.
So, and if that goes on, you end up that this girl keeps on killing herself, or she keeps on blaming herself for the parents or anything like that.
Mm-hmm.
Then the other thing is, because the girl is young, she's not mature yet, mm-hmm, and she doesn't know that much.
Mm-hmm.
She will end up doing things because she's still a child, mm-hmm, basically. So she will end up doing childish things. And the man, because he's old and he has knowledge, so what will happen is violence, domestic violence will increase due to these age differences, and they do not connect anywhere.
Mm-hmm.
So there will be a lot of domestic violence, and the person who will be suffering will be the young girl.
Yes.
Now, the thing is, you also find out that this girl, when she's married, when she's very young, she cannot continue with her life. She cannot discover her full potential,
mm-hmm,
because she will be trapped. Most of the times where these marriages normally happen is in those rural areas where people have not yet developed well in terms of being civilized.
Mm-hmm.
Now, this girl, that means she will be a housewife. She cannot have a chance to go back to school, educate, mm-hmm, herself,
mm-hmm,
and maybe become an independent woman. So she'll be depending on somebody. She cannot be able to explore her full potential. She cannot be able to release the dragon in her and make sure that she becomes what she wanted to become. So it's like she's enslaved in a circle where she cannot come out.
Mm-hmm.
So when we look on the other side now of the men,
mm-hmm,
men also, you know, the African culture, you need, even for me before I got married, I had to go under a series of counseling and guidance, because when you get married, there's a lot of things that comes with it. And there's a lot of things that need to change.
Mm-hmm.
So not unless if you go under serious and a very effective guidance and counseling,
mm-hmm,
there's no way that marriage will last. There's one person will be suffering.
Mm-hmm.
And that is what happens when these young people who are married, they don't have any direction, they don't have anybody to mentor them, they don't have anybody to guide them. They end up getting into self in a place that they cannot get themselves out.
Mm-hmm.
So there's a lot of things that are involved in that. Like we say, they drop out of school,
mm-hmm,
domestic violence comes in, traumatic stress, and I don't know whether there's anything else you would want to share on the effects as well.
Yes, definitely. You know, there are a lot of things that come with child marriage.
Mm-hmm.
And we would like to, you know, help make the listeners understand,
mm-hmm,
that this is a problem that, mm-hmm, we cannot stop talking about.
Yeah.
Because, you know, and more so, you look at the arranged marriages.
Uh-huh.
This is mostly, they are the people mostly affected by this.
That is true.
Yeah, because you find that, you know, a family enters into an agreement to marry their daughter,
mm-hmm,
or marry their son to another family.
Yeah.
And then some of it, it's because of the social and the economic forces.
Mm-hmm.
Sometimes they want to, you know, reduce the burden.
Mm-hmm.
Sometimes they want to, you know, they feel like if they don't marry this girl, mm-hmm, she might end up, you know, doing something that they don't want,
mm-hmm,
socially.
Yeah.
So it is, there are so many effects that come with it.
Mm-hmm.
These girls drop out of school.
Mm-hmm.
These girls get, you know, early pregnancies,
that is
which
true,
at times bring a lot of complications.
Yeah. Yeah.
because some of them have not developed very well, and especially their organs are functioning.
Yeah.
And then there's a lot of it, some of them get into depression.
Absolutely.
Because, you know, when you are forced, if you want to get to a marriage or to get married to somebody that you love or somebody that you desire to, even if you are not at an age that is acceptable, but, you know, are you getting into it forcefully, or are you getting to it by will? You know, it affects the psychology, it affects the mental, you know, and somebody gets into stress, and which will lead to depression. Some of them lack the potential know-how of how to deal with the family. Like, for example, if you marry a 12-year-old girl or a 14-year-old girl, or let's talk about 17-year-old girl, some of them don't even know how to nurse a baby. They cannot even give, you know, an advice to a family, or, you know, I remember when we were in school, there's one teacher called Mr. Oteng when I was in primary school, and there's a story he was talking about that sometimes you just find a girl leaving school here and going to get married to a boy from this same class. And then now you have two children, you know, married together, getting another child. And then people, you know, when problem comes, a number of three children crying together, because the baby will be crying. And the husband, because they cannot, you know, sit down and solve a problem, will be crying.
Absolutely.
The mom, because also they don't have the technical know-how of solving a problem, she will be crying. So we have three babies crying in this house because they cannot manage.
Nobody can help anyone.
Yes, the responsibilities that come with parenthood. So those are the effects that, some of the effects, because we are not saying all of them. There are a lot of effects.
That is so.
And, you know, when we come back again to the reasons or what leads to early marriages, you've touched on the rural areas, and I would call it poverty-stricken regions. Some of our girls are, you know, forced into these early marriages because the family maybe sees somebody who's got money, and you know, they feel that if we give away our child, we will be getting some wealth back as a dowry and sort of things. There's also what we call, you know, lack of parental guidance. Some of them lost their parents at a very tender age. You know, their parents die, and therefore there's no one to guide them through. And because of suffering, they don't have somebody who can see them through. They only feel that the right person who can, you know, see them is if they get into a marriage, you know, with a certain guy to take care of them. And then they end up getting married before they get to the right age. We see also the burden and economic liabilities. Some families, and I've heard of this many a times in some of the families back in my country, in Kenya, where a family feels that a lady is a burden. You know, you're thrown away. They throw you away. They say, no, I gave birth to a girl. So this is a burden that's going to come, you know. So instead of, you know, wasting time taking her to school, and then after taking her to school, we'll give her away. Better we give her away at this age so that she can be taught by the husband, or maybe, you know, some communities, they do that.
That is true.
Which makes them, or make these ladies vulnerable as they are. They get into early marriages. There is also what we call the peer pressure. And James, I want us to take the last remaining minutes to talk about peer pressure, because this is the most problematic thing that is affecting our society today. The peer pressure, you find that a lady maybe was married at 18 years, right? And she gets a very wonderful, you know, marriage, and things are colorful. The social media is colored with a lot of, you know, luxury things, a lot of goodies, and, you know, she feels very well at home. And then this vulnerable lady at 16 or 15 years is suffering. She's at a very, you know, tough times at their home. Then she feels that, oh, my friend Judy was suffering just like me. But today, look at her on the social media. They are sharing a lot of things with their husband, which sometimes is not true. Which sometimes you'd see what we see in Facebook, what we see in Instagram, sometimes are not true, or sometimes it happens once in a while.
That is true.
And, you know, the difficult part of life, we don't share it on social media.
Absolutely.
So the peer pressure, what do you say about it? And how do you advise our ladies who are watching this outside there?
Well, I think there is a puncture, if I may, so somewhere the society have experienced a puncture or a flat tire where they were supposed to not to, it was not supposed to be there actually. You have these people, a group of ladies, like say the generation that is there now, it's a materialistic generation. And they believe when you want to be happy, you must be wearing expensive clothes, you're carrying on a Gucci bag, you're putting on Gucci sunglasses or whatever, you're driving a Rolls Royce or Ferrari, but they don't want to work for it.
Yes.
Yeah, and they believe that they just want to get them, and they don't want to work for it. So you find that most of them end up, especially they get that mentality when they are 15 and all that because of the exposed to media that is happening right now. So you end up, you find out, and the only people who have those kinds of things are the old men who have worked for the whole of their life, and now they get the money, they start suffering. Because when you are young, not unless either your family is rich, but if you're hustling from the beginning, there's no way you will get money when you're 20 or 25. So these girls end up putting themselves into these kind of these traps, and they end up suffering because actually the person who takes you, we call them our sponsors back home. When a sponsor takes you, he's not taking you for forever. He's taking you to pass right. When another new product comes, takes it.
You are taken to the garbage.
Yeah, you are taken to the garbage. Now you go back to church and you start praising God and praying for a husband. So that is the peer pressure that is there, that you must, for you to be respected in the society, you should have something that shows. And you should have something to show on social media. It is something that is affecting a lot of ladies, and it's also affecting men nowadays. Because now you find the same way you have very old, well, some of them are old, not too old, but quite old ladies who have got money, and they are trying to now to
sponsor
get,
the
young
boy
men.
Child.
Yeah, man, because a man wants to be seen with the Jordans, golden chains, and all that. So he falls in that. Now, when, especially for men, it's actually even more difficult because when you get into yourself into one of those ladies, it's very difficult for you to come out. For the sponsors, they will use this product, drop it, and then take another product.
Yes.
But for a lady who wants to take you and control you and take, not the whole lady, I mean the sugar mommies.
The sugar mommies.
Yeah, because I know my wife is watching this movie. So they will want to take you and control you. So you will not have your life as it should be. And you end up suffering alone. You end up being in a very bad situation. But because you want people to show you and you want to see, you want to be like your friends the way they were or the way they are, and you want to show yourself, you end up suffering and living a miserable life. So peer pressure is quite a big thing, and it's affecting a lot of people. Maybe if I might add on, if we're coming out from the peer pressure a little bit, just if you will permit me only like 2 minutes, not more than 2 minutes.
Come on.
Culture also plays a very big role. There are those cultures that, like today I was watching a documentary from Bulgaria, I think. And I was so surprised to see it's also in Bulgaria, they do these early marriages. And actually, you are not. It's not like the way we do the ceremony. You are sold. So they prepare you. You go, and then it's like you know, like the old slavery times.
Yes.
They sell you. You get. You go with your husband, and they have the wife and the husband take the money, and that's it. And they have totally accepted that culture. For them, it's not wrong at all.
It's
something that is very, very, very good. Also, I was watching another one from Central African Republic. This girl was married when she was 12 years old. She got married. She could not refuse, according to what she was saying. I cannot refuse to get married because if I do, I disobey. I don't know what my fate will be. Yeah. So I have to agree to get married. But she was saying that she is not happy. She is suffering every day. And she wishes that she gets a chance to go back to school. So these cultures that are being brought up in a way that they are putting other peoples into miseries, they mm-hmm. should actually be looked into, and we try to stop them. Because times are changing.
Definitely.
Definitely we should change. We should yes. not change in a few, in certain ways, and certain ways we say we will not change.
Yeah.
So those are the only points I think we should emphasize on.
I think, thank you so much, James, once again for talking about the culture and, you know, speaking. And this what you've mentioned. You know, we are a society where I think sometimes I say we are not realistic to mm-hmm. ourselves. Mm-hmm. Because on one side we say we are civilized, mm-hmm. but on one side we want to protect the cultures, even yeah. the olden days cultures that doesn't picture the what we call civilization.
Absolutely.
So, you know, and even the religious side, mm-hmm. the same thing now comes to the culture. Mm-hmm. You find that our cultures want us to accept that we are civilized, yet there are some things that we don't want to civilize.
Absolutely.
Like what you've said, the examples yeah. you've given. Mm-hmm. A country is civilized, but they're still selling their daughters
yeah.
to husbands or maybe whatever they can call it. Mm-hmm. A country is civilized, yet corruption is something that some people are still praising.
Yeah.
A country is civilized, but the culture of the FGM is still mm-hmm. practiced and yeah. it is honored. But you see even the leaders, some of the leaders supporting it.
Absolutely.
A country is civilized, but still early marriage is supported within a certain culture. And uh-huh. it is a culture that is practiced, that is, you know, worshipped.
Yeah.
So how can we get into talking and, you know, break down and cut on this such kind of cultures? Because mm-hmm. the girl child is at... You know, prey. She's like a prey. Mm-hmm. There is just somebody waiting to climb.
Yeah.
The boy child also is on the other side, because you've talked about boy child as mm-hmm. well. We don't just want to talk about the girl child being married early. The yeah. boy child also, they're the sugar mummies, the sponsors,
yeah.
mothers waiting for them somewhere, just looking at them, you know, to take them at all. So,
yes.
in summary, child marriage is something that is there.
Mm-hmm.
It's something that must be stopped
yeah.
by all
means.
Possible means,
mm-hmm.
and we must preach about against it.
Yeah.
We should not stop. We should rescue our girls. We should rescue our boys, and the sponsors, mm-hmm. both men and women.
Mm-hmm.
Please, let's calm down to our senses. Let us be in a society that is, you know, reflecting what we are. Be the guide to these children, to these young ladies.
Mm-hmm.
Be the guide to these young boys, instead mm-hmm. of, you know, using them as a hyena, if I may call it, right?
Yeah,
so
yeah.
my conclusion is, we are a family, we are a society that cannot accept child marriage. We mm-hmm. have to speak against it
mm-hmm.
in whatever means possible.
Yes. Absolutely. I think the only thing I can say, I'll close by a phrase that says that true love waits. We'll give everybody a chance to explore their potential, give everybody a chance to do what other people will do, because we are all given equal chances. So we should not stop people from exploring their potential. Everybody's great and everybody has greatness within them. Let's give them a chance.
But that's very well explained, James. And it's always beautiful to have you here on this show, James. And we want also to appreciate the work that is being done from the other side.
Yes.
Our camera person, he's doing a great job. Thank you so much for being with us. Sometimes you don't see the people who are behind the scene
mm-hmm.
because this thing don't just happen like a manna from heaven. There are
Absolutely.
A lot of things that entails what this work is.
Mm-hmm.
So until we meet again next week, when we will be discussing the advantages that come with early marriage, because mm-hmm. look at it this way. Anything on this earth that comes with the disadvantage mm-hmm. must have an advantage.
Yes.
But that doesn't mean that we have to support it. We have some advantages that we can talk about, but then we cannot support it because of those advantages. Because
mm-hmm.
the thing is, the disadvantages are more than the advantages. Therefore, that is why we say no to early marriage.
Absolutely.
Until we meet again, it was your host, John Gora, and my co-host,
James Mumbi, a.k.a. Kishuru.
Thank you.
And also, bye-bye. Don't forget to like. like our page and comment on our YouTube channel. And we say, if you do that, we will be moving together to the great world. Peace.